beba firimbi, wear comfortable shoes, and carry drink water today. We are going to shout tomorrow. Huh? Na ukiona polisi hapo, I've been hit with a tear gas canister on my hand and I couldn't move that hand for 3 days. And trust me, these things are going to happen. So let's go on the streets. Let's be, oh God, this is so annoying. It's so angering. If you don't have enough reason, they are banning Kware. They have added 7 shillings on fuel. And Wamuratha has called us Mungeke people and we deserve to be shocked. I don't know what more anger you need. Anyway, Jojo, I've been seeing your hand up. I'd like you to speak.
Appreciate it for the chance. How y'all doing tonight?
Go ahead.
Yes. Man, I've been having a long day looking at those pictures. The movement is still on. I'm still hustling from a corner in this world. Yesterday, I went to some celebrations of Black people, and I did not see a Kenyan celebration like African countries, Sierra Leone. It's called a carnival. It was somewhere in Baltimore, Maryland. So basically, it's the, you know, diaspora people dancing. You know, you have a track where you have a generator, music system, people dancing, being splashed with water. And this is the happiness I'm wishing for the Kenyans, for the young Kenyans. I want them to go on the streets at times and just have some fun. Life can be everything. All day work, no play makes Jack a dull boy. Let me go to the point that I want to touch. After this is all said and done, Githurai will be the spark that ignited fire in the entire world for the light, for the creed that all life are created equal in the entire world. We Kenyans, with the cradle of the world, it's time for truth. Kenya and God cut Williams in 2024. We ain't going back. If you are following, come with us. But it's the time to use common sense, stop paying debt before food, nigga. Now about death, because we have turned this into a game of death. Bwana Ruto, Christianity, where are you? You have shown us that death can be done so easy on our brothers. Young brothers, our mom's asking, Karisho, where are you when the kids are dying? I just cried like a little bitch. Kenya, we're gonna change some things. It's not even time for leadership. Something like death, then it need to be a subject in our secondary schools. If death gonna be done so easy like this, we know, we had the gunshots that happened in Githurai. There were more than 300. And now you say you banned the Kwale? You know, most in the house, most in these spaces, and some of them are coming with an agenda. I've been listening to some most. Some of them coming with the agenda of LGBT. Africans, Danley Fused with their behind. And the entire world is coming for your behind. You better know that. I lived in Hollywood for 4 years. 50% of the gay people who live there are gays. I don't know why they want this chocolate from the Africans so bad. The advertisement, everything. My people, watch out for your behind. You come in with the LGBT, you know, agenda. We can sniff it from a distance. Because it's like someone coming double-sided. If you come in with an agenda to kuangamisha my family, my ability to have kids, with some other agendas, bro, I can't even give you a platform to tell me shit. If you come in with an agenda for LGBT, this is not the place for that bullshit. The triangle. Life is a triangle, the way they play this game. And this triangle is enhanced by titles. Kenyans, we're shooting these titles. We're making these MP titles so horrible to work. A work where someone can go without food because they went broke, just like other professions. And to add, with the biggest of them all, we need a stipend. Each and every of these Gen Z need a stipend of 5,000 shillings every goddamn month. If we are fighting, they better give us this $5,000 by next Monday. $5,000. The money we are getting. Don't be paying goddamn debt before food. We need food. Everybody hungry. The first thing when we did, we went to the parliament, we ate. These niggas been holding meetings. They can in fact provide you seats and food for them to tell you their goddamn story. We're also gonna stop this, you know, goddamn bullshit of we all going when we see someone with his a goddamn entourage of cars. We go by the roadside. They need to come somewhere. It's alleged food. Give us some goddamn. Every meeting starts with food. $5,000 stipend. We need to be fighting for stipend, like the developed countries. Niggas get some money every month. What the fuck? People gonna get some money. The first thing that need to change, even before we got them, Luto must go. My people, I love you. Another day, another dollar. Kenya revolution. Gen Z, Kenya revolution. And Tuesday, we bring it up. But my people, be together. Because these niggas are now killing us. Be together. They're taking advantage of us, man. These soldiers are indisciplined. You see, Kahawa, it's like the devil's part. Githurai, I'm from Githo. I used to drink with these cops. And these Githurai cops are compromised now. Because they're the ones who probably did this job. More than 300 people, my people, I'm telling you. After the story is said, Githurai gonna be the spark that ignited fire. A fire that will never be stopped. To bring the African child equal standards. Life is created equal. This triangle, one teacher talking to 40 students, one politician talking to 1,000 people, one person, one motivational speaker talking to goddamn too many niggas, telling them bullshit. This triangle gotta go, these titles. Let's shit these titles, my people. I love you. Jojo Shukali, Ruto must go.
Hey, my people, Ruto must go. Hey, moto. This government is burning a crime scene, the place where the bodies were dumped. Instead of removing them, excavating and investigating it and get to the bottom of it, they have decided to arson the crime scene. I'm telling you guys, do we have a country? Tuko na nchi? Dr. Mjulus. Hey, yo jina yako bana. Mjulus, shika mic. Hey, daktari. When I read it, it had not yet sounded in my head. Anyway.
Hey, my friends, good morning.
Good morning.
There is a beautiful conversation we are having. First of all, let me say Ruto must go. I support that fully. All right. And, you know, I was listening very keenly to some lady here, former speaker. And she said that, you know, in this process of removing Ruto from power, you know, it is a process. It is not something that is happening out of blues. It is a process. So in this process of Ruto must go, we must be ready to die, right? Everybody in this movement must be ready to die, led by myself, or beginning with myself. Because the moment we go to the street demanding for these MPs and Ruto and blah, blah, blah to vacate those offices, we are actually chokozaring bees, tunaenda kwa beehive, tunataka kwenda kwa beehive, na atujaenda hapo na nini, na protective gears, you see. Tunaumwa na manyuki hapo hivyo. Wengine wakishaumwa na nyuki, wengine wanasema si tumechoka, si tumeogopa. So we must be ready to face these people. Because remember, we have a situation where politicians will always divide and rule. All right? They will always try as much as possible to divide us along ethnic lines, along class, and what have you. So as young people in this pro-Ruto, anti-Ruto movement, let us stand together and speak in full accord and tell this government that you fucked us. It is time for us to fuck you. Okay? Because, you know, just firing a cabinet, according to me, I don't think that was fulfilling. The firing of the entire cabinet, with the exception of Musalia and Rigiji, that was not fulfilling to me, because I believe that the back will always stop with the head. It is the head that must roll. Okay? When a certain CS is plundering government money or embezzling government money, that is in full, the president is fully aware. There is nothing that can go on in any ministry without the knowledge of the president. So as Dr. Mjulus, I support this. I will always be at the forefront to ensure that my country is led in a manner that is satisfying to all and sundry. And then I have seen the former Prime Minister, Raila Odinga, and his brother too. Of course, I listened to his brother yesterday, talking about a government of national unity. These people, we must discard all of them, whether you are a Luo, a Giriama, a Kikuyu, blah, blah, blah. All these people, we must discard them. I saw Raila yesterday at Kware. People are chanting, Ruto must go, Ruto must go. You know? And Raila, we have mastered this politics. Everybody knows it's politics. That after the election, he is always up there to seek for Mkate Nusu. Na hiyo Mkate Nusu umekataa. Na ndiyo maana pale jana Kware aliambiwa, hatutaki hiyo Mkate Nusu. Because huyu jamani anatuua. Okay, so as we march tomorrow, the message must be very clear. We don't want Ruto to be in that office. Okay, and then after Ruto is removed from that office, hii idea ya sijui Gachagua kuwe number two, sijui speaker, ama sijui chief justice, that is bullshit. If we are putting everything to a stop, everything must come to a halt. Kila kitu, we sweep this, we sweep everything. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Daktari. We have to sweep everything. I agree with you 100%. Let me give the microphone to Lorene. Welcome, Lorene. Lorene, can you hear me? All right, Lorene, you can't be heard. Ken, are you there? Mutwiri. Ken Ukwapo? Ken, unanisikia?
Yes, my brother, I'm around.
Oh yeah, continue.
Naomba nasikika, si ndio?
Vizuri tena.
Yeah. First of all, I'm here to greet everybody. Siyesema good morning, because in Kenya there is no any good morning we can get because of the foolish and the kind of people you have put into the offices of power. So, first of all, I will start by asking, where was the National Intelligence Services? Where was the NIS when our people were killed and dumped in Mukuru Kwanjenga? Sipare. Where was the DCI? Eh? How comes somebody like a man holding a higher office of the DCI came and tell us that the bodies dumped in quarry. Maybe it is cultism. I don't know. Eh? Siji Uchawi. What is that now? Why can't he come clearly and say that kwa upande wangu mimi, nikiwa kama mkubwa wa DCI, nimechoka na kazi. Naomba, niondoke. We can accept. We talk and we enter zako, then we prosecute you because you allowed, ulikubali tuwakupatia kazi, na huku sema, sisi the guy who give him the job. I don't know ya sira tutapeleka wabi. Maybe State House. Then tukuje tena. Tuulize a story about the national debt. Tunasikia etiyo kuna madeni kutoka kwa Kibaki, madeni kutoka kwa Uhuru, then madeni ya Ruto. Why should I pay any debt? Na mimi nikitoka Tao usiku kwenda nyumbani, mimi najimulikia tochi yangu. No light street the street lights. Hakuna street lights kama ziko maybe Nairobi, those big cities. But ukiingia Ushago, my friend, yani Kajiado town kubwa, light street hakuna. Mal almost 500,000 people wako hapo kila siku wakifanya kazi, jioni wanalipa tax. Imagine there is no street lights. Why? Because of the people we have put in those offices, and they must all go. Kesho, by the way, kesho, point yetu inapaswa kwa hivi, tunapaswa tusimamie State House. Na tupaswa kusimamisho na mtu kwa barabara. We are the majority. And what we are doing is what is right. We elected them. They never elected themselves. We are the people who voted. They never voted themselves. Maybe those people, even they don't have even those kuras. Mchinga mtu anakuja anaanza kutulipisha ID. Eti ID ikipotea, unalipia sijui elfu, sijui kufanya ID aje nini. How comes we are paying to be Kenyans? So maybe I should be born anywhere else, but not in Kenya. Because how comes I be born here, then I pay to be a Kenyan? When will this nonsense stop? Eh? So the kusema, I don't know, you have resolved the cabinet here. Haujafanya kazi yoyote. Do like this. Do an honorable thing. Behave honorably. Do like this. Bugey and ICC, the International Criminal Court, Koome with Kediki. Because the people who have been dying, nobody had a gun. Hakuna mtu alikuwa na buduki, ikasemekana sio mtu wawe. Hakuna mtu alikuwa na mawe. So how can we allow to be killed? Then after people have killed us, they now go, they say, I have resigned. How? We should find where this Japhet Koome is. Tumtafute mpaka kwake nyumbani. Then we resign him. Tumtoe kwa hiyo kiti. Hata si kumresign, alisha resign, but tumpeleke ICC. Kama si ICC, we prosecute him. On our own, kama hatuna mtu wa kutusaidia. Then these government bloggers, our hashtag is Ruto must go. Then they are coming with their own hashtag. I don't know, wamelipwa na Itumbi wakuje watupoteze. We should not allow that. So if you have been following any government blogger, unfollow him, unfollow them, and block them, and mute any information coming from a government should not reach to us. Until they come to the ground, we listen to them. Tusikie wanataka kusema aje. unfollow all of them, unfollow William Ruto, unfollow that Rigathi Gachagua huyo jamaa afungagi mdomo, meno iko nje kila wakati, unfollow him, unfollow them, unfollow this Dennis Itumbi, unfollow huyo jamaa wa State House huyo mwenye haezi kaa kwa jua, anitangu waju jamaa anakuanga na sura ya sijui, I don't know inakaa aje. Unfollow them, unfollow all of them. We should not be controlled by such people. Eh? Mtu kama mimi hata baiskeli sina boda boda. I have got nothing, but I let and somebody to help me who cannot even pay my even for a single semester. Sijui kesho tutokea aje, guys. Sisi watu mina ngoja watu wakuwe na hasira mingi. Tutoke kwa nguvu. Carry your phone, carry your placard, carry the flag of our nation. Come out. Tutoke kwa nguvu. Be very peaceful. Ili wasipate kitu ya kusema ndio tumewashoot, they were not peaceful. Ndio tumewashoot. Is my time over?
Hey. Malizia.
Oh, my time is not over.
Oh, it is over. Very over. Malizia. Oh,
okay. To watch and tune Malizia very to be very clear. To say me heavy. The political class, the likes of Raila Amolo Odinga, people like oh my God, ni Malizia tu baba. People like this Oburu Oginga, people like Edwin Sifuna, Babu Owino, how are to our pastor kuingilia movement yetu? Our movement is ours. They are coming. How watu sijui walikuwa anafanya nini mkuru jana. We could have even stoned them yesterday. I don't know what they were coming to do yesterday. To do what? Walikuwa tu wanakuja kutuchekelea. Hakuna mtoto wa mwanasiasa amekufa, my friend. Watoto wale wamekufa ni wa wazazi wa kawaida. The political class should not even be around when you are exercising our power, because for now the power is within our hands. So nikimalizia, let us resist all of them and greet them. Tuwasalimie wote. Ukipatana na mtu mahali tumsalimie kwa hiyo kijiji yake, tunamsalimia. And I'm through, my friend, and I very thank you, Afrocentric. Thank you. Na hasira isipungue hata kidogo. Mungu awabariki sana, na kesho tutokee kwa nguvu.
Thank you. I wish all Kenya had your passion, had your vision, and understood the movement like you understand it. We cannot be infiltrated by Azimio politicians, by Kenya Council politicians. This is organic. And we are fighting a well-oiled machine, and they have a war chest of finances. Right now, Atiruto Maste is a sponsored hashtag. A sponsored hashtag cannot defeat a hashtag ambayo imetoka because of our collective consciousness. Tunaisikia kwa roho. Yani kitu tunaisikia kwa roho. Ruto must go. Ametuo, ametu abduct. Rex Amenda, our first martyr. Sai, wananza kuchoma mamwili hapo Kware. Kware is on fire. I put the video on the nest. Manze, everyone, subtweet this space. Ruto must go. We have a new co-host, Wesley. Karibu, hebu tusikie sauti yako.
Mimi napataka kusikiza tu wasepa. All I can say, poverty in Kenya is man-made. Hakuna Kenya si poor. Like you can see these politicians wanakujanga na projects as make sense. Unapata ni ukambani mandizi hazifanyi huko, but all of a sudden wanasiasa huko wanakuja, yani napeana tu mfano. Ati huku Ukambani tunahitaji mandizi. But in real sense, unajua Ukambani kitu inafanya kwa ni maembe na machungwa. So instead we invest kwa hiyo maembe, hiyo mtu akitaka akijua, mtu akitaka maembe anajua, but nitaka maembe poa, naenda Ukambani. And then wanakuja pia side tuseme Western pale mvua iko maembe ifanye poa, wanaanza tu project ya maembe. Yenye it makes sense. Yaani hao watu wanaudhi tu. Ukiangalia kama mademu hata hawa mademu wenye walikuwa na wenye wanaenda Saudi, hawa mademu Moses Kuria, hawa mademu walikuwa na around 1100 za huko Saudi. Moses Kuria kuenda tu huko 2020 tu huko. Mlimuona alikuwa ameshinda anaenda huko. Akaongea na watu wa huko ama demu sahi wana 800, 900. Yani government, we are tired of everything. Yani ukisikiza watu, unasikia tu pige mtu nguvu. Then, manze niko na hasira, acha tu points itakuja.
Haya, haya, asante Wesley. Wacha nipatie mic to the Kingsman.
Hello. Afro.
Hey, not you. Hello, Kingsman. Wewe umeingia saa hii? Hebu kunywa chai kwanza. Hapa kwa speaker panel hiyo coke ni yako. Enjoy it. Get ready for tomorrow. Wacha ni Kingsman. Poor bit wait. Kingsman, can you hear us? No, you can't hear us. Okay, can you hear us?
Yes, I can get you.
Yeah. Mic is yours. I yield it to you.
Yeah, mkwaje? I hope you guys are annoyed.
Tumekasirika.
I'm annoyed. I'm really annoyed. Nimekasirika. So, acha nianze na kusema. If these investigators have confirmed that these bodies were found as a result of cult, why are they burning them up? Why are they burning the bodies up? Mbona wanachoma bodies? Kama walijua they are a result of cult, wangenelea kutoa bodies, wazidi kufanya more investigation, wapati ni nani alikuwa anafanya cult. But why are they burning them up? Mbona wanachoma? Because I'm sure there are more bodies there, and wanajaribu kuclear evidence. Eh? So, tusiache hao watu wazidi kufanya vitu zao. They are burning the bodies up because they know there are more bodies there na Kenya watazidi kuasirika. Mi nimekasirika hadi voice yangu inatetemeka. Today nimeamka napata kwari.
Bwana, mimi hadi nimeshindwa kuongea. Ongeendelea.
Jana I saw a body. Aitwa Jikale ama siji nani. Bana body kichwa imepasuka bana. Kichwa imepasuka, then they are burning the body. Man, tears were dropping bana. Tears zilikuwa zinanitoka. These guys, they're trying to clear the evidence. Mbona kama wanajua bodies is a cult, mbona wachome bodies? Why are they burning them? Then Ruto comes and say ati jana alienda church na sema tumetenga makwapa, tumetenga nini honestly? Tumetenga nini? There's nothing like that. Kesho tutoke. We are ready to die. I'm ready to die personally. If they want to kill us, let them kill us. We have nothing to lose. We are jobless. We are Kenyans, we are jobless. We have nothing to lose. We are jobless. Then they go ahead. Polisi ana protect mtu anafanya investigations za nini? Investigations gani? If he's doing his job, why do you protect them? Then you come and burn the bodies up. Some bodies, there's this lady mwenye the body ilipatikana with placards and the Kenyan flag stuffed in her mouth. This girl, I think she was strangled to death. Then I think she was raped because she was half naked. But we are either tutasikia, we want tutasikia ni cult. Hao watu wa cult kwani walikuwa wanachukua tu watu na placards na the Kenyan flag. Is it even making sense to you guys? Then hii hashtag ya Ruto Must Stay naona inajaribu kutrend. These guys are paid. Mtu anaenda hapo anasema ati sitaki kuona hii hashtag ya alafu anaweka hapo hashtag ya Ruto Must Stay ikitrend ili ajaribu kutufanya tufikirie ati they are not paid. Na anasema guys, honestly, people are dying now. We are playing with their lives. People are dead. Please, guys, tuache kuwa na mchezo, honestly. People are dying. You don't know. Inaweza kuwa wewe. Inaweza kuwa wewe anytime. Do you know the government? Hawana nini? Hawana huruma. They can pay you today, then tomorrow they come for you. Guys, let's be serious. Alafu kina Raila. Someone better anawafuata. Mnawafuatia nini? These guys are murderers. Raila, in the recent years, this guy amekuja after elections, after election, after election, looking for the mkate nusu. Ati anataka kuhelp controlling. It doesn't make sense. People are dead. Bodies zinachomwa. Do you know there are some people in Kibra and in Rongai that will never get the bodies of their loved ones? Because bodies zimefichwa. How comes unaamka asubuhi unapata ground iko na blood but there are no bodies? Kwani what were killed there? Blood ilitoka wapi? Kwani kulikuwa unanyesha blood? Mademu walikuwa unanyesha kwa streets? Please guys, it doesn't make sense. So, mi Kenyan has advice now. the Law Society of Kenya, please, you guys go camp in Githurai and Rongai. Bring your camps. Kill them too that feels like they were affected. Mwenye anaogopa that akiongea kwa social media atakujiwa. Guys, go camp in Rongai and Githurai. Then iteni watu. Mwenye anafeel alikuwa affected aseme, yo, I'm not seeing my son, I'm not seeing my daughter, I've not seen my dad for the last 1 month, for the last 3 weeks. Let them come and wawapatie ma statements zao, because bodies zenye ziko huko mbona zinachomwa? Wanachoma evidence. Do you know some people are not going to get their bodies, bana? People are not going to get their loved one. Utazika nani? Utashanga tu mtoto wako alipotea, but ujaimpata for other 10 years, bana. Utakuwa tu like, mtoto wangu alipotea, but ajaikuja. Hiyo kitu itatoka kwa moyo wako. Your heart itakuwa ina... Guys, so Law Society of Kenya, kindly, to push your information, then let them camp in those places. Watu waende, they make state, waandike statements. Because these guys, on government wanasema ati, there was no massacre. So let's prove them wrong. Watu waende waseme, kama ulilu, ujapata your beloved one. Kindly, go write a statement. Law Society of Kenya, wakue na the statistics, wakue na the stats, wakue na the numbers, wajue this is what happened. Hata kama tunaanza the investigations, tunajua na wapi. Because Article 244 imekuwa affected vibaya sana. We've not seen the police doing their job. They are supposed to be protecting us, lakini they are not protecting us. They are not protecting us. They are killing us. They keep on killing us. But if you see their living standards, it's even worse than ours. It's worse. So I wonder, these guys are like, they are like dogs. Umea mbwa, once ameonja damu, atazidi kutaka yo damu. So the politicians are using these guys. How comes mtu anakuja usiku bana, usiku sanane, satisa, kuabduct mtu? Yo ni overtime bana. Na alipu extra. These guys are dogs. So the government is using these guys. Guys, lazima tutoke on Tuesday kesho, kila mtu, then our hashtag naona mnajaribu kufanya inakufa. Kindly, kama uko hapa, tafadhali, right now, tweet, Ruto must go. Before nimalize, tweet tu sahi, Ruto must go, kindly. Tweet, Ruto must go. Mwenye tweet, we ni kama, you don't even care. Just tweet right now, Ruto must go. Because hiyo hashtag ya Ruto must, hata sahi kusema, hiyo Zakayo lazima sijia abaki. It's wanajaribu kufanya itrend, but it should not be the case. Please, tomorrow, kila mtu atoke, and we have to die for our nations. The lives that were lost, azikuenda for they didn't get lost in vain. Na lazima kesho kila mtu atoke. Ruto must go. Thank you.
Afro, mambo moni.
Mambo. Is that Kingsman talking?
Can you hear me?
Kingsman, that's you.
Nikasi was killed.
Is that you, King?
So mine, first of all, hii historia Itumbi, by the way, kama mnataka kuget Itumbi will hang out. There's a mall in Kiambu Road called Theater Mall. And then there's a place